as we come to you from Baltimore, Maryland for today's game. We're underway here. No return. The ball's coming out to the 20. Running back in motion here. Toss play. That tackle was made at the 27-yard line. And that's the type of run I think this offense would take all game long, Phil.
Oh, would they ever? They would love this. This is showing your dominance here. The offensive line doing a good job, but also a solid job by the running back picking up some good yards.
And that'll be a gain of about two. In 2014, he went from journeyman to star player. Keep an eye on running back Justin Forsett.
Yeah, if you talk about a player that just came out of nowhere and was outstanding, that is Justin Forsett, and he just knows how to run and pick up those extra yards every single play.
That's a gain of 10.
Jim, let's keep an eye on the defense. If they keep giving up runs like this, they're going to have to change what they're doing on the defensive side. Maybe bring another guy down in the box to stop those runs.
The Ravens have it at the 39. The Ravens go back to the ground. Brought down at the 44.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
And here we have second down. Tosses the football.
What a good job by the running back that time. He reads the blocks very well, and he picks his way through there and picks up a first down. That's nice.
Looks like they're in press coverage here. The Seahawks with two extra defensive backs in the dime. The Ravens take it from the 43. Allen's got it on the toss. Not able to get away from Chancellor.
Allen's a very smart runner. He knows situations in the game. He saw the first down yard markers, and what does he do? He gets past them and picks up the first down.
Play number six coming up on this drive. Let's see how they back up the big play here. Joe Flacco will take it right from the center. Staying with the ground. Not able to get away from Chancellor.
The Ravens, they believe in their offense. They know once they get inside the red zone, they can run or throw. That time they run the football, and he picks up some good solid yards. Great job by the offensive line.
Again, they'll lean on him. The Ravens now move the chains.
The offense is so close right here. They just need to show a little power and punch this in the end zone and get that touchdown.
Goal line defense on the field. Gives it to him again. Avril's all over that offense and brings him down. Taking a look at the linebackers. They're young. They're unheralded. But they do know how to make plays. The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. Second and goal from the 4. Flip to the outside. Runs it across for the score. Touchdown. As we get near the end of the opening quarter, they grab the lead with that touchdown.
Yeah, things have been rough so far, haven't they? It's been fun to watch. Each team is being very competitive and physical, but that's a nice thing to do, to score that touchdown and get a lead here late in the first.
The Seahawks are set to return the kickoff. Upshaw's there to take him down. That return's good for about 23. Wilson's lined up. No extra blockers for this snap. Graham's got the catch and the first. First down coming up. Wilson's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Wilson finds Lynch. Lynch is taken down at the 40.
Running backs are such a big part of the pass game now in the NFL. Look at this play, able to take a short catch and get a long gain out of it. Nice job by the running back.
Coming to the line at the 40-yard line. Press coverage all the way. Quarters formation here for the defense. He pulls it down somehow. The offense coming to the line inside the opponent's 20. The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Makes the catch in the end zone. Touchdown. And it didn't take long for them to get this game right back to even here in the second quarter.
Yeah, that was a nice drive on the offensive side. That makes you feel good. And you just to execute so many plays and find a way to get down there and score a touchdown.
The Ravens' return team is ready. And they crash into him, ending the return at the 20-yard line. The Ravens back onto the field on offense. The last time they had the ball, it resulted in a touchdown.
Listen, if I was them, I would keep on running the football. They have a lot of runs at their disposal. I know they have a big game plan as far as what to call these kind of situations. They're dominating the line of scrimmage. Don't get away from it.
They went with the ground game on first down, bringing up second. They're going to run it on the toss. Sherman's able to read that play and make the hit.
The Ravens offensive coordinator, he has to be frustrated by that play. I think he calls the right play, but what happens? The run loses yards. That's just a bad job by the offensive line.
Playing press coverage to the outside. The Ravens snap it at the 26. Flacco to his tight end, Pitta.
This team, one of the better tackling teams in the NFL, and they play the situation perfectly. They give up the short completion. They come up and make the tackle. Now we have a fourth down.
The Ravens believe they can pick up the first in this short yardage situation and keep the offense on the field. The Ravens will take the snap from the 30. The Ravens turn the ball over on downs.
The Ravens go for it on fourth down, and they do not get it done. Now it's up to their defense to bail them out.
What a place to start for the offense. The Seahawks offense coming back onto the field. It was a good drive for them last time they had it, all the way down to the end zone for the touchdown.
Yeah, you know, in this game, Jim, it's all about momentum. And when you feel you've got the momentum on your side, you got to take advantage of it. So now I think it's up to the offensive coordinator to call the right plays.
They come to the line of scrimmage, first down. Off that time.
Gets tight down here in the red zone. So if you're a defender, read the quarterback. You make a quick break on the football. Hey, you get in position like this, you can knock it down.
Second and goal from the 8. Got hit on release.
Jim, I love these situations. Third and goal. What are they going to call? They're going to run the football. They're going to go with the pass. If it is a pass, I would look for something quick.
Third and goal from the 8. Wilson's gonna scramble. Wilson's off the mark there. Incomplete.
Wilson's able to get outside the pocket that time, and it's a good job getting outside the pocket, but there's nowhere to throw it. The pass is incomplete.
The coach is going to go for it. From the gun, Russell Wilson ready for the snap. Wilson standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. The Seahawks turn the ball over on downs.
The Seahawks decided to go for it on fourth down that time, and it didn't pay off. But, of course, the coach, look at him now. He is second-guessing his decision.
Backs to the wall for the offense. Looks like they're in press coverage here. They're setting up screen. A gain of 9.
The Ravens coaching staff, they have been smart today. They are keeping everybody off balance, even me. I thought for sure they would run the football, but no, they come out on first down, they throw it, they pick up solid yards. Good job by them.
The catch is made by Justin Forsett, and he's going to be tackled right around the 31-yard line.
Jim, this time it's a halfback screen. Nice job by the quarterback. The halfback, good job after catching it, picked up some good yards.
The Ravens come out with a split backfield. First down at the 31. It's Earl Thomas who makes the tackle. A very close game to this point, but if you look at the rushing numbers in a tie game, you love seeing a running back that is having it his way.
They have run the football so well, you have to just sit back and say sooner or later they're going to fake that run and throw the football down the field and get a big play, because I think it's there.
And here's the toss. The one who made the big stop.
The Ravens running back that time, he makes a bad decision. You can't be looking to make every play a big play when you're running the football. Look for a few yards, take advantage of that. He tries for the big play. What happens? He gets tackled for a loss.
The Seahawks come out in a dime package. Just a quick drop back. Got a flag. That's what happens when you try to guess the snap count. No surprise, it's another third down stop, and this has been a first half where both of these defenses have had the upper hand, Phil.
Yeah, it's been physical, it's been fast, and it's been good. Now I'm talking about the defenses. On the offense, the best thing they've done is not make a major mistake to put their team in a hole, so the second half is going to be interesting to watch.
After the incomplete pass, it brings up second down. Toss to the outside. Brought down at the 47-yard line.
If you want to run the football with success, you're going to have plays like this where they pick up very little yardage. Don't listen to the fans. Keep running it, and it'll work.
Third and 7. Toss to the outside. Shakes off the hit, and they advance the ball onto the other side of the field.
That was an awesome job by the running back that time, breaking those tackles. In the NFL, the low man wins. That time, the running back was the low man.
First and 10. And now here's the toss. Space to work. They'll mark him at the 22.
Jim, they got momentum on their side right now. They are making everything work. That was a nice play. They pick up another first down, and they got a good drive going here. When you see linebackers like this shifting, they're trying to confuse the quarterback.
Set up now at the 26. The Seahawks defense now loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense. Out to Smith. The Ravens signal for a timeout. They have 2 remaining. Should be what we call a gimme. The kick is good. The field goal to take the lead here late in the first half.
A lot of good signs for this football team. Taking the lead. We've had some good coaching so far. Some good play by the players. Man, nothing but positive feedback so far in this game.
And they stop him from running it out to the 20. Mark him down at the 19. And with that, we'll switch sides and take a breather. We've reached halftime here in Charm City. Back to Baltimore for the second half in just a few moments. Tackles made right around the 25-yard line. The Seahawks offense trots out onto the field looking to get into the end zone and see if they can turn the tide in this one, partner.
Well, the fact that they are losing this game so far, the sense of urgency is there on the offensive side. You know, you have many plays in that playbook. I think they need to try a few different ones here in the second half.
And in for the touchdown. You talk about halftime adjustments, Phil. They come right out here in the second half and score the touchdown to go in front.
Yeah, I think here's what happened at halftime. The coaches went in there, yelled at them, got them scared, and it made them sharpen up because they looked really sharp on that drive to score that touchdown.
The point after try is in the books. Steven Hauschka ready for the kickoff. Touchback as he's tackled right at the 20. The Ravens talked things over at the intermission, and I'm sure one of the first orders of business was to try to figure out a way to get this offense going, Phil.
Absolutely. That's what you want to do, and I think you do that by play call. So the coach, they have many plays that we call drive starters. Catch the defense by surprise. They need to call one of those right here and right now to get this offense going.
Lamar Aitken has the catch. That pass play picked up only 4. Second down and 6 coming up. Pittas lined up outside on the right. Flacco will take it from the gun. Marvin Brown with the catch. He'll pick up 7 this time.
The Ravens, good job that time moving the chains, picking up that first down. And Jim, of course, there's no time to panic in a situation like this. I think they know that. It's in the second half. You're down just a few points. Just keep looking for ways to get another first down, and that'll serve your team well.
Second down and 3 following that nice run. The Seahawks will come out in the dime. From the gun. Brown makes the grab. Brown's met after a gain of 8. Mark him down for another reception. Well, we're anxious to hear the full story on that injury. Let's go down to Danielle Bellini with the story.
Guys, I just spoke with a Ravens official. Right now, all they will say is it's an upper body injury and that he will not be returning. Back to you. In addition, the staff will confirm an exact timeline for his return right now, guys, but he will be dealing with this injury for at least a couple weeks.
And it'll be second down and 6 after the running play on first down. Pittas on the right side, split out wide. Out of the shotgun formation. Marvin Brown with the catch. Gains 11.
The Ravens did a good job that time picking up the first down. Let's look at the situation. You're behind in the second half. You keep looking to pick up those first downs, and, you know, you get enough of them. What does it do? Pretty simple. It leads to a score.
Flacco's completion percentage, 80% on the day. First and 10. And he's taken down.
You're talking about a bonus. When you get a defensive tackle that can get in the backfield and sack the quarterback, that is something special. Great job that time by the big D tackle.
The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. Flacco's going to take it from the gun. Incomplete, almost going in the other direction.
It's not always about being safe on third and long. Every coordinator has a group of plays that they like on third and 15 plus. So it could be seams, double moves, plays where you catch the defense by surprise and you can pick up a very tough first down situation.
On the money. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down.
That defensive coordinator came up with a terrific game plan today, Phil. So far, not giving up very much at all here in the third quarter.
Well, the defense is playing so well. I'll bet you the coordinator wishes his contract was up so he could go in there and get some more money, because he's done a terrific job and the team looks extremely sharp.
It'll be a touchback. The Seahawks offense taking the field again. They got everything they could out of that last possession, Phil. A solid touchdown drive.
Yeah, what a productive day so far for the offense. They're mixing it up well. They got confidence. The quarterback's throwing it well. This is a very good game so far.
It's Jermaine Kearse coming down with it.
Well, the defense, they give up a first down there. They're behind. They just can't sit back there and keep bending. You got to take some chances. Go on the offensive, on the defensive side, and just make things happen.
Press coverage all the way. They're back at the line after that catch for a first down.
Russell Wilson will take it from the gun.
Looking across the middle. The defender able to knock it away.
So many times when you drop a football in the NFL, a pass like that, it's because of lack of concentration. You're just not serious about what you're doing.
The Seahawks from the 37. Sucks behind the line of scrimmage.
Nice job that time for the outside linebacker getting the sack. They ask a lot of these guys now. They are special players in the NFL. Stopping the run and the speed to get outside and get the sacks on the quarterback too.
This is third down. The Seahawks at the line of scrimmage. Split backfield. Wilson's back in shotgun formation. Going deep, and it's batted down.
The Seahawks don't have a lot of options on third and long situations. The pass goes incomplete, and the defense did a good job of staying back there and not giving up the deep throw.
And it'll be Ryan back to punt. Taking it back the other way. Real good field position here to start this series.
Wilson's ready for the snap. Empty backfield. The Seahawks will take the snap from the 30.
Wants to go deep.
Tries to get the feet down, but this will be ruled incomplete. They went for the home run ball there, Phil, but just could not make the play.
Yeah, you want to do this. You always want to throw the football deep at least four or five times a game because you want to make the defensive backs uncomfortable. If you let them get comfortable, they'll start jumping those short ones. These guys won't do that anymore now.
The Seahawks will take the snap from the 30. Makes the catch, but didn't get the feet down. Incomplete.
Interesting situation here for the offense. They got a lead here in the second half, but it's third and long. And you always like to say, the football is in the hands of the quarterback, so he has to be smart. If he tries to force it down the field, I do not like his chances.
Following that incompletion, it sets up third and 10. Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. Wilson from the shotgun. Throws the pass. It's intercepted. Tackles made.
Phil, this defense has been making plays all season long, and today they do it at the right time, late third quarter in a close game with the interception.
Well, once again, they have set up the offense, and let's see if the offense can finally come through and take advantage of that turnover or that tremendous interception by the defensive player.
Playing press coverage to the outside. Toss to the outside. Picked up a couple that time.
We enter the fourth quarter. A very closely contested defensive battle. And Phil, these offenses been held in check all day long. What might be the mindset right now going into the last quarter?
I think that, you know, when you have a game like this, it's low scoring going into the fourth quarter and it's close. You've got to be on the offensive side very careful. Make sure you don't take chances where you make a mistake and you can end the game for your team with that mistake.
After the 2-yard carry, it sets up second down and 8. Joe Flacco will take it right from the center. The final quarter begins with this snap. And Urban's all over the ball carrier.
The Ravens offensive coordinator, he has to be frustrated by that play. I think he calls the right play, but what happens? The run loses yards. That's just a bad job by the offensive line.
Third and 9. Incomplete. The hit jarred the ball loose. It's almost as if they're running out of ideas, Phil, for ways to unlock this defense. Now into the fourth quarter.
You would think so, Jim. When you watch what they're doing on the offensive side, they have no answers. But when you can't block them, it's hard to have success on the offensive side.
This punt will be returned. And they get to him at the 45. And a run back of about 7. The Seahawks have to still be thinking about that last possession. They were actually moving down the field. And then, of course, the untimely interception ended things.
Yeah, the defense, look, they got good players. And, you know, you give them enough chances, they're finally going to make the play. You have to be careful with the football. The offense was not, and that's why it resulted in an interception.
What do you think they're talking about in that huddle after that drive-killing interception?
They're probably telling the quarterback, if you do that again, we're going to kick you out. I don't know, but they got to play better.
Looks like they're in press coverage here. Quarters formation here for the defense. The Seahawks will take the snap from the 45. The ball is knocked out.
Well, it's do or die right now, and you've got to go ahead and make the call to give your offense a chance to get this first down. And I know this team, they have a lot at their disposal. I think there's a play in there that's going to give them a good chance.
Jackson's lined up in a single back formation. Ball's incomplete. Fourth down coming up. Looks like they'll go 3 and out on this series. They're in punting formation. Is kicked out of bounds. The Ravens offense comes back onto the field. Let's see if they can move the chains this time, because the last possession was ugly. They weren't out there very long.
Jim, you know how I think in situations like this, I think it's more up to the coach than the players. Call a play that really catches the defense off guard so you can get an easy gain and get the momentum on your side and get it rolling.
The Ravens now march to the line. Tightly contested game here in the fourth. The score's 14-10. First down at the 15. Rubens all over that offense and brings him down.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense, and now they have a good situation.
From the gun, Flacco. Almost intercepted.
Well, but it's third and long. I just say this, be very careful on the offensive side.
On the way, third down. Flacco by himself in the backfield. Play clock's running down.
They're changing things here. The quarterback changing. He's giving the receiver some new instructions.
And he makes the catch. No, the ball comes out. The ball is knocked out of his hands. And And so now they'll bring out Cook to punt.
And now they call the quick timeout. Sam Cook for the punt. Wants to give it a go here. He's going to be tackled right around the 49. That return's good for about 12. The Seahawks offense is on the field, hoping to erase the memory of their last drive, which was completely unproductive, a quick three and out.
Yeah, it was. I don't know if they can erase this defense. This defense is pretty good. We saw that in the last drive. They got good players, and they're pretty excited, so this is going to be tough on the offense.
Rams got the catch and the first.
The Seahawks really got it going now. They got confidence. They got momentum. They got a small lead here in the second half. And that first down, what does it do? It just gives the offensive coordinator confidence. And, of course, this quarterback, he is always ready to go.
The Seahawks have it at the 39. Launching it deep. Seattle is in for the score. Touchdown. That's his second touchdown today. The Seahawks now lined up for the extra point. Oh, he actually misses the point after. The Seahawks getting ready to kick it off. That's a touchback, and the ball will be spotted at the 20. The Ravens offense coming back onto the field here, desperately trying to avoid a repeat of their last drive when they had the quick three and out.
I'll tell you what, if they go three and out again, you know what's going to happen? Those defensive players are going to be looking at them as they come off the field. You put this back out there already, so it's important to get a drive, give your defense a little rest.
The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. Midway through the fourth quarter. Pulls it in. Second and two coming up. Flacco from the shotgun. The Ravens get a first down.
Well, when your team is behind, what do you do? Just come out there and get a first down. That's a nice job by the offense.
Press coverage all the way. First down here after the completion. Flacco flings it way down the field. Has the catch. Oh, that's one of the best one-handed catches we've seen all year, isn't it?
Jim, that's one of the best. You don't see many this outstanding in these wide receivers. If they can't get two hands on the football, they've taught themselves over time just to go up, stretch as far as they can and get that one hand on it, and it is amazing how many times they make the catch.
Could have been intercepted. Second down, late in the fourth quarter. Second down and 10. Set up screen. Tackle made by Bennett that time.
That's what you call a bullet pass. Very little space to throw the football into, but he gets it done. A lot of velocity right on target.
Third and 10. He's hit as he throws it. Tucker's lining up for the field goal. He's one for one so far today.
And the kick is good for three.
They get the field goal, Phil. Is it too early for the onside kick?
It is too early, Jim. You know, I'm just saying it. Not getting on you, but you're just not a very good game manager. You kick this thing off, and you put the pressure on your defense.
And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. The Seahawks offense getting ready to start this drive, and things are looking good for them at this stage of the game, partner.
Yeah, this is where it gets tough, though, Jim. They got to find a way, make the right play call to get one first down. If you do that, that puts the other team in a very tough situation.
An extra tight end on the field for this one. First down at the 22. Here's the quick toss. Arrington's able to read that play and make the hit.
That's just the right call to make in this situation. Just run the football. Don't try to be some genius and catch the defense off guard. Manage the clock and just get this game over with.
Second down and 13. Wilson's on the move. Looking long. Pass is intercepted. Tackle's made. The Ravens have saved all three of their timeouts for here in the fourth quarter. Now on first down, every snap crucial the rest of the way. Brown's got it on a pass, had some heat on it. The Ravens call a timeout, their first. First down, pressure on every snap now. Out of the gun. Fights through contact. Pass is made, but the hit knocks the ball out. Incomplete.
Good timing by the defensive player that time. He gets to the receiver just as the football is getting there and makes the hit, knocks that football loose.
The Ravens come to the line of scrimmage with two timeouts to play with. Second and 10. And now on the draw. Picks up about five. This is an almost must convert scenario. Third down coming up here in the late stages. Yes, that's four down territory, but you don't want to face make or break at this point.
Yeah, on the defensive side, now it's time for the coach to do his job. Be aggressive. Call a defense that the offense has not seen so far today. If you do that, I think you'll catch them by surprise.
In the late going, the football in position now in the red zone, and here the defense knows this is where it cannot buckle.
What makes it so tough for the defense is in the red zone that the offense has a whole new set of plays once they get inside the 20, so you got to be looking out for everything. The quarterback's picked up on something. He's changing the play here.
They'll take it at the 20.
Wonderful job by the defense that time. They stayed after it. And inside their own 20, they finally come up with the play. They get the interception, and they keep the other team from getting points on the board.
Playing press coverage to the outside. First down at the 20. He makes the catch. And that's a gain of 10.
If it was me, I would cover the short receivers and force this guy to throw it down the field. You're behind by a few points. You got to try and force the issue.
It was a nail biter.
but it goes down as a victory.
It's even sweeter when you win a close game.
Used to rock an MP3, before that, hot tracks and MTV. Now I synchronize the MPC, so this draft genuine like OMG, yo, G, yum. Y'all in the booth like DB. LOL, old school, I'm so PC. See the mic, I gotta grab it, no CD. You're playing the odds when you face the mob. See the guard raising the ball, have the yards, don't get it. I'm hard in the paint when involved in again. I might roll up in the tank, dog. Ain't no limit. GOH, haters get DDT. Is that it what they used to be? It's funk jock in the guard on court. Like a CP3, it's about time y'all get used to me. Because
I know.
Seahawks, Panthers, coming up on EA Sports. We welcome you to Charlotte, North Carolina for today's game.
The running back position today, manned by a couple of stars of the sport. What are you looking for here?
Yeah, it's kind of refreshing, isn't it, to do a game where it's all about the running backs. We have to talk about the how good the quarterback is, and aren't they special? Well, these two running backs are special, and we see it each week how they play, and then also we see it how the offenses are designed. It is around the running backs.
Looking Looks like they're in press coverage here. First down at the 17. Rubens, the one who made the big stop. Just a very scary place to be so early in this game for the offense.
It really is, and it's just when you're in a situation like this on offense, especially as a quarterback, you have to be careful. Don't turn it over because that will give easy points to the opponent.
Loss of four on the play. Ted Ginn has the catch. Picks up eight here.
The key to being a really good route runner and running these drag routes across the field is show some courage. Don't worry about what's in front of you. The quarterback will take care of that.
The completion sets them up now for third and seven. Newton's got it in the gun. He'll throw it over the middle. And he's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down.
Good job by the defense. They're well taught, well schooled by the defensive coordinator. They know in situations like this, if it's thrown short of the first down marker, they're good. They come up, make the tackle. Now we have fourth down.
The Panthers showing no fear this stage of the game, and they're going to go for it. Newton in shotgun formation. And it's caught by Stewart. Stewart's brought down, but not until he gives his team a new set of downs. First down on the way. Newton's all by himself in the backfield for this snap. Dropping back now into the shotgun. Jericho Cotchery has the catch. Cotchery's tackled down after a gain of 10.
The drag route is a huge part of every offense now in the NFL. It's where the receiver starts on one side of the football, goes across the field, looking for those spots where he can catch it. And the quarterback that time threw it at the right time, right on target. Good yardage, just short of the first down.
The Panthers will take the snap from the 40. Olsen's got it. First down.
You got to be able to adjust when you run these drag routes across the field. The throw cannot always be right on target. Can you reach behind, make the catch, and keep going full speed? That's the sign of a good receiver.
First down and 10. Brown hauls it in. Breaks out of the tackle. No one's going to get him now. All the way home and all alone. Touchdown.
Well, we're talking about some of the fastest humans on earth. And we take into account you can't touch them or breathe on them. That's how they're able to get open and make so many catches.
The Panthers lined up now for the point after. And the extra point is good. The Seahawks are in shape now to return the kick. Charging ahead just across the 20 and tackled at the 21. From the gun, Jimmy Graham with the grab. Pass complete, but did not get them the first, so it's second down now. Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. Here's the handoff to Marshawn Lynch. Looking at third down. They bring in the extra tight end. Wilson's going to take off with it. Had it, but dropped it. This defense off to a terrific start.
Well, they call third down the money down because you try to keep drives going. And right now the defense has all the money because they're the ones getting it done.
The Seahawks will go for it here on fourth down and short. The Seahawks will take the snap from the 30. Wilson finds Lynch. Lynch is able to get the job done and picks up the first down.
The Panthers defense has to be demoralized by that fourth down conversion allowed.
I think any time on the defensive side when you give up a fourth down conversion, it is heartbreaking, and it has to be heartbreaking for the defense right now.
With the contact, the ball comes out.
Marshawn Lynch found a second win for his career when he came out to Seattle.
He did find a second win, no doubt about it, Jim Nance. And I'll tell you, he got bigger, stronger, and he's as tough as I've ever seen him. He is a perfect fit for the Seahawks.
For this play, they'll go with two tight ends. The Seahawks will take the snap from the 35. Jacobs is going to make the tackle. As we set now, the defense, remember, he was the defensive player of the year in 2013, and he is Luke Kuechly.
Every defense would love to have a middle linebacker like Luke Kuechly, just where they can read the plays, get to the guys, make the tackles. Just a hard worker and a great leader.
Third down. Quarters formation here for the defense.
Quarterback likes what he sees out there outside. He's changing the play with the wide receiver.
Looking to go down the field here. And it falls incomplete. Back from the break, and the second quarter is now underway. John Ryan will be called on to send this one down the field. Again from the 14. He's taken down at the 23. That return's good for about 10.
The Panthers heading back onto the field on offense. They scored on their last drive, Phil, and they did it with a blistering aerial attack.
Quarterback is hot. He is getting protected. Oh, man, what do you do now? I think if you're an offensive coordinator, it doesn't matter what you call. You know your guys are going to make it work.
And looking underneath, this will go incomplete. That leads us to second down. Stewart is in the backfield. The Panthers now move the chains. The Panthers are leading in this one, and a lot of that goes back to the play of this quarterback, Phil. Newton's been on the mark to this point.
He has. He's one of the better throwers in the NFL. When you give him time like he's had here so far today, he is going to put it right on target.
Stewart's got it on the toss. Now they'll try over again on second down. Cam Newton will take the snap out of the gun from the shotgun. Climbs the ladder, and he has it. That's another reception, giving him two. First down, offense readying for the snap. After the long gain, let's see what they do here. Newton's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Very nearly intercepted. Second down after the incompletion. Newton's got no one behind him. Just a quarterback waiting for the snap. Out of the shotgun. Looking across the middle. Intercepted!
Good job that time by the defense. Not being fooled. Being in position. When you're in position, you have a chance to make the play. That time they did, they got the interception.
The Seahawks heading back out there on offense, hoping to improve on their last possession, which ended rather quickly with a punt.
Yeah, I think what they got to do, they got to come out and be a little more creative, get the defense off guard, make them think over there. That was too generic what they did on the offensive side. If you want to score, show some ingenuity.
The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. Second and 13. He robs him of the interception. He turns around and defends the pass.
Sometimes on third long from the defensive side, I like the fact that you can blitz. Send more guys than they can block. Make the quarterback throw the football quickly and short. Then it's all up. They're coming up and making the tackle.
And it's caught by Curse. It's first down as they head to the line. Press coverage all the way. Staying with the passing game on first down. Wilson with the reception.
Nice job that time by the tight end. Makes the catch, and you got to look out for him now in the NFL. Remember, they're usually the closest receiver to the quarterback. Quarterback gets in trouble, he's going to look for the tight end.
That long gain sets them up here on this play. Throws the pass. The ball is taken out of his hands.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit there, don't you, Jim? They are all open receivers, all over the field, nowhere to throw it, and it just results in an incompletion.
Second down following that incompletion. Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. Wilson's now going to leave the pocket and intercept it.
Nice job of the defense that time. In position, they read the quarterback's eyes, and it led to an interception.
The Panthers retaking the field with their offense in a game that hasn't been very pretty here of late. Turnovers by both teams on the last two possessions.
Well, define the word pretty. I think if you ask the defensive teams, hey, they love this game. It's beautiful. So far, the takeaways by the defense, that's the story.
First down at the 15. Newton to Olsen. We've hit the two-minute warning here in the first half. Newton has everybody split out wide for this snap. Second and three. That's Newton over to Olsen for the catch. Quarters formation here for the defense.
Now he's going to change the play. Look out. I think he's going to go down the field with the football.
And he comes down. No. The defender tips it out.
Got to give this secondary credit. In this passing league now, it's hard to make plays, but a good play there and another incomplete pass.
Newton standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Getting away from the pressure. Has 12 on this play.
Well, there's under 2 minutes to go. Good job by the offensive ball carrier that time. He knows he can get no more yards. He steps out of bounds to stop the clock.
Stewart lined up in the backfield. Now first and 10. Jonathan Stewart with the catch. Second down. The Panthers load up the backfield for this next play. And now Newton with Avril brings down the
quarterback.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit here. You want to stop the offense from scoring here with under 2 minutes to go in the first half. Good pressure on the quarterback, and they take him down behind the line of scrimmage.
Play number six coming up on this drive. Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. Third down and six. And that's Chancellor, who almost came away with a pick.
It's a good job that time by the defense on third down. Find a way to get off the field. The defender found the way. Knocked that pass down.
The Panthers have to punt the football. Favorable bounce this time as it's headed to the end zone for a touchback. The Seahawks offense can reignite things now after last time moving the football only to throw a drive-ending interception.
And this is what this defense lives on. They thrive on it. They let you move the football a little bit, but they wait for that mistake. Is that mistake going to be an offensive penalty, a drop pass? That time it was an interception, so that's what this defense does, and they do it well.
The Seahawks are at the line of scrimmage with a pair of backs split behind the quarterback. It's Jermaine Kearse coming down with it. The Seahawks call a timeout and are left now with only one. First down here. Marshawn Lynch is in the backfield. He'll throw it over the middle. Luke Wilson has the catch. The Seahawks will use a timeout here. They'll talk it over before running a play on first down. Playing press coverage to the outside. Here's the first snap after the big play. Complete. Touchdown. Boy, things suddenly feel a lot different as that touchdown ties things, Phil, right before the intermission.
Oh, yeah. It just changes everything. It puts one team in a funk because they let the other team tie it up. And, of course, when you're the team that's behind and you score that touchdown to tie it up before halftime, man, that makes you feel great.
Whitaker on the return. Still on his feet. And the tackle's made right around the 32-yard line. And we'll be back to Charlotte after the break for the start of the third quarter. Welcome back, folks. Jim Nance and Phil Simms here at Bank of America Stadium for the call as the second half is about to get underway. And they're all over him at the 18-yard line. The Seahawks offense comes onto the field after a tie ball game through two quarters, Phil.
Usually in the second half, offenses kind of get the advantage. Why? Because the defense starts to tire out a little, and you can spring different plays on them because you've learned what they like to do. Can they come out here and take advantage of this defense? I think they're going to have a good drive right here. That's a wonderful job that time by the secondary. Everybody's in position. Nowhere for the quarterback to throw the football, and it leads to another incomplete pass.
Wilson from the shotgun. Wilson's taking off. He's got a little bit of daylight here. Gains 12.
Always be alert for this quarterback to run the football when he gets the chance. He is excellent with it. He is a quarterback with the abilities of a running back.
Wilson's alone in the backfield. He'll take the snap from the gun. Wilson's on the move. Looking long. It's intercepted. He's brought down just out of the half, and it looks like the defensive adjustments have paid off.
Yeah, good job at halftime. The defensive coordinator went in there, got some things straightened out, and they came out, got the job done, and picked off that pass. almost to the 40 at the 39-yard line.
First down at the 39. Has the first down and a hold on board. What a run by Stewart.
The Panthers offensive line will be whooping it up tomorrow when they watch this play in the field room. What a good job by them. Excellent planning and awesome execution.
Looks like they're in press coverage here. First and 10. Newton, handoff. And that'll gain just a few yards.
This is one good tackling defense. They stay in good position at all times. And we saw it that time, and they stopped the play for a short game.
They come to the line at the 31-yard line. The Panthers come to the line with an empty backfield. Cam Newton takes it from the shotgun. And incomplete as Olsen can't hold on.
Sometimes when you have a player with this kind of talent, you're willing to put up with a few drop passes because when he catches it, he has a chance of going all the way.
It's third down coming up. Newton's ready for the snap, empty backfield. The Seahawks will use a timeout here early in the second half.
At the 31, here we go.
The Panthers come to the line. The first down marker is at the 24. Billy Brown with the catch. That's reception number two for him.
You run that drag route across the field, it is not as easy as it looks. You're running fast. You have to catch the football right in stride, and you cannot see what's in front of you.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. From the gun, Newton. Newton hooks up with Greg Olsen. That pass play wasn't good for much. So now it's second down and 9. The Panthers with an empty backfield look here. Newton's going to take it from the gun. Over to Greg Olsen with the reception. Play number 6 coming up on this drive.
Teams in the NFL spend about 30-40% of their time all week long practicing plays in the red zone. So there's a lot they can do here. Let's see if they come up with something that works.
The offense heads to the line for the 7th play of the drive.
Doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals.
When you get third goal, a lot of times it just comes down to who's willing to fight the hardest. We'll find out here in a second.
Newton's completion percentage, 70% on the day. Offense still looking for a first after that completion on second down.
Cam Newton will take the snap out of the gun.
Newton to Olsen. Should be an easy one here. And he converts here on the field goal try. And as we near the 4th quarter, that field goal has put them in great position to take control of the game, Phil.
Yeah, great job getting the field goal, and I'll tell you what it does. You know, late in the 3rd quarter, there's limited possessions left in the football game. Now you got to manage the clock the right way and coming out here with a victory.
The Seahawks offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim, but you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about footballs.
Pass is intercepted. We're getting close to the final quarter, and this offense now has a chance to build on its lead.
Yet, if they go out there and score now on the offensive side, what are they doing to the other team? They're putting them in some known situations. So the defense will now know that the opponent is going to have to go out there and throw because they're behind in the game late.
The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. The Panthers will take the snap from the 45.
Gains 14.
Keep the momentum on your side. You got a lead here in the second half. Nice play that time. You pick up the first down. Let's see if you can take advantage of it.
First and 10. Handoff to Jonathan Stewart.
Stewart's brought down after picking up only a yard. He's now averaging 6 yards a carry on the day.
Second down here.
The Panthers lineup split backfield. He'll take the snap, the first here in the fourth quarter. And the catch is made by a Jericho Country.
Third and 5 still to go, even after that last completion. Press coverage all the way.
Screen.
Reaches out and snatches it.
This will be a field goal try for Gonneau.
The kick is good.
Well, that time the offense had great field position. They don't take advantage of it, but at least they get 3 points. Good job by the kicker coming in and getting some points on the board.
No return here, and Wilson will come back out at the 20.
The Seahawks offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake the last time they had the ball. The turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim, but you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go. Go out there, be aggressive, and see if you can score some points. The Seahawks look pretty confident out there on the field, don't they? And they're very calm, and they should be. That first down, they're right in this game. Don't look down the field for that big play. Just keep marching.
First down at the 35. Going for the deep ball, but it's incomplete.
Good job that time by the secondary. They're in good position. They make the play, and it's an incomplete pass by the quarterback.
It's now second down.
The Panthers lined up in the nickel. Russell Wilson will take it from the gun. Charles Johnson gets to him for the sack.
Every defense is looking for somebody to hit the quarterback, and the best person to do it is the defensive end. What a good job that time by him.
Third down now. Wilson's back in shotgun formation. And the reception by Doug Baldwin.
Big first down by the offense that time. Here in the second half, they're losing a close game. And you get that first down, it just gives you confidence. It opens up the playbook, and it just gives you a better chance of going down the field and getting the score.
And it's caught by Purse. He's brought down at the 23-yard line.
There has been good pass protection for the quarterback all day long. He has not been sacked much, and he throws it there and gets another completion.
Playing press coverage to the outside. Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play.
Gets it out for the completion. And that's Tillman in on the stop.
That was a nice job by the offense. It just puts them in a better position. Nice little throw and catch. When you get down in the red zone, the offensive coordinator's got to call a play that deceives the defense. Let's see if he can do it. His team is down. He needs a big play here.
This play will hold up. He's inbounds.
The Seahawks just picked up a big first down that time, Jim. When you're down in the second half, every first down is crucial. Nice job that time by the offense.
The offense heads to the line for the seventh play of the drive.
Defense lining up here late in this one, trying to hold on to the lead. A game breaker. Touchdown.
Man, the defense has to be down at something like this. They allow the offense to score that touchdown in the red zone. My gosh, you only have such a small part of the field to defend, and they just didn't get the job done that time.
Makes the PAT. The Panthers are prepared to return the kickoff.
Webb's going to test the coverage here. He's brought to a halt and a run back of about 18.
The Panthers stepping back onto the field to get this next drive underway. Their previous possession was a field goal.
Yeah, I think they feel good about that field goal. They made some good plays, and they got down there, and they moved the football, and they got in position where they could kick the field goal. Now you take the knowledge that you gained from that last drive, use it, and try to go down there now and score a touchdown.
They've got to be wondering, though, can they finish off a drive today?
Newton in shotgun formation. Ginn has the reception. Third catch today so far.
The Panthers, good job that time, moving the chains, picking up that first down. And, Jim, of course, there's no time to panic in a situation like this. I think they know that. It's in the second half. You're down just a few points. Just keep looking for ways to get another first down, and that'll serve your team well.
The Panthers have not needed to adjust this aspect of their offense. Olsen shown great hands and an ability to find open room in that secondary.
Yeah, he's absolutely shown that he has some talent, and nowadays it's just so easy to get the football to the tight end. Look how close they are to the quarterback, the short throws. You can put it right on target, and they're just piling up the numbers.
A huge third down play on the way. Cam Newton takes it from the shotgun. And it's caught by Stewart. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
What a nice job on the catch this time and breaking the tackle and getting those extra yards. When you make plays like that, if I was a quarterback, I'd give you a few more chances with the football.
Now on first down, every snap crucial the rest of the way. First down and 10. Newton's pass will go for an incompletion.
That's what you expect in the NFL nowadays from the players, especially these receivers. They're so aggressive, so athletic. They go all out for every catch. That time, he just lets it all go. Not able to make the catch, but I'll give him an A for effort.
From the gun, Newton. Looking across the middle. Brown's met after a gain of 8.
The defense is going to play conservative in situations like this. They have a lead here in the fourth quarter. They'll give up those short throws.
Quarters formation here for the defense. Third and 2. Every play in an NFL game is huge, but when you're talking about fourth down with the game on the line, well, this could decide it all.
So hard to stop an offense 4 times in a row. This is going to be interesting to see how the defense goes about it.
The Panthers getting set now for what would be a winning field goal on an afternoon we will long remember. Fourth down, and the coach is going to go for it. And here's the throw. Cam Newton, and intercepted. Newton's going to be kicking himself for a long time when he thinks back on that interception. A critical error at the worst possible time, Phil.
Oh, listen, it was the worst. It was bad timing. I'll tell you, the coaches might be trying to kick him too, because that took all the chances away they had for winning this game.
Takes the knee.
A pair of true defensive efforts that stood out, but in the end, it's a win for one side, even though the offense did not come out impressively.
When you see a low-scoring game like that, Jim, it means one thing usually: a lot of hard hitting. It was tough to score, conditions were tough, and hey, no matter how you win, you are happy.
So for Phil Simms and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nantz saying so long for now. Chargers, Seahawks on EA Sports as we come to you from Seattle, Washington for today's game.
When you look at this matchup, you've got to talk about the deep threats, the guys that can go long, and two of the best, speediest receivers in the game are going to be on the same field today.
Yeah, it's going to be fun to see how they, both teams, the offenses, how do they get the football to these speedy wide receivers. And no matter what you do on the defensive side, you go, well, we're going to take them out of the game, we're going to double team them. Really, how are you going to do that when they're in motion? They're always changing formations. Very tough to do now. You just got to rely on good tackling and try to prevent those short catches and long runs.
That return's good for about 27. Double tight end formation. He fires it. Here's the group that perhaps has the game's biggest assignment, the offensive line. Coming up, second down. Looks like they're in press coverage here. Defensive lineman who can dominate a game, Michael Bennett.
It is all out every single play in the Super Bowl in the 2014 season. He was absolutely magnificent. He almost won the game by himself. The quarterback, he's changing the play with the wide receiver with those hand signals.
And it's knocked down.
The Chargers really don't have much of a chance of picking up this first down. It's third long. Of course, the defense is looking for passes down the field. They're all over everything, and the pass goes incomplete.
Looking to make a difference.
Ball is out.
A huge turn of events. The ball's going back the other way.
This game is still about hitting. When you hit the other team hard enough, that football comes loose. Nice job by the kicking team. They make the hit, and they recover the fumble. Great job.
The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. Trying to find an opening to the right.
And he gains maybe three.
That's a nice, powerful statement as they establish the run at the beginning of this game.
Jim, you're right. I'm going to give the offense a little credit here, but, you know, somewhere, I don't know, maybe the defense is going to have to put some weights in their pockets. You got to hang in there and make the tackle.
Two tight ends on the field here. The Chargers will take the snap from the 35.
Intercepted!
That brings the play to an end. I know this never happened in your decorated career, but an early interception, how will he rebound the quarterback?
Now, I'll just say this, you're a funny guy. That's funny. I did it all the time, and I used to tell my offensive lineman, be ready. I'm probably going to throw some more.